गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. लॉन्ग डे हाँ, लॉट ऑफ टेक्निकल जार्जन थ्रोन अराउंड. वेल आई एम गोइंग टू डू द सेम. सो दिस इज़ फॉर द एनहांसमेंट टू द ओपन एडेक्स HTML एडिटर. सो यू माइट सिंस मॉर्निंग यू माइट हैव हर्ड अबाउट ओपन एडेक्स IIT बॉम्बे एक्स विच इज़ अ डेरिवेटिव ओपन एडेक्स. इट्स अ लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम वेर इट हैज़ टू इंस्टेंसेज, अ CMS एंड एन LMS. A CMS is a content management system which is used by course authors, whereas LMS is a learning management system which is used by learners, students. So a CMS consists of a lot of components to create a course, to organize it. One of it, the component which is really crucial, is the HTML editor, which gives you the ability to write the course content other than the videos or the problems. Now this HTML editor, now of course Open edX has come a long way from maybe 6 or 7 years of the course it has been in the world, and it is one of the promising MOOCs platform, but still everything is not perfect, and the HTML editor has some bugs and some shortcomings. Our objective will be to enhance the limited abilities of the Open edX HTML editor, and also to find possible solutions to the bugs in the current editor. Right now, if you log into Open edX or IIT Bombay Access and go CMS and keep on creating sections and components, and then you stumble upon the HTML editor, there you will find this is a visual editor. It is as good as a PowerPoint slide where you can put text, format it, formatting screen. Whereas it has edit HTML option where you see the HTML window. Now as you can see, quite visible? Now I don't mean the text is readable or not. Can you see there is an HTML some code written there? So if you see, it doesn't have any indentations. Now even if you type it in the form of indentations while writing it, if you save and close it and open it again, all the indentations will go. This is one of many issues. Other is it may or may not support all the HTML or HTML5 tags. Other thing is it does not support internal CSS. So now if you want to write, really show a big text page which has a lot of formatting, every time you have to write a CSS for inline, and it does not take a function-wise internal CSS. So these are the planned enhancements. Just like I said, indentation, all the HTML tags, JavaScript, it has its own mind actually. This editor has its own mind. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Some things like some special characters, like if you write ampersand, like if I want to write IIT Bombay X and Open edX, and if I choose to write ampersand instead of AND and I save, it throws the junk code. In the problem component as well happens the same. Internal CSS, I just said about it. Well, now you all are maybe second year, first year students? Second year. So you might have written code in HTML. And what kind of editor do you use? Maybe Notepad++, Sublime, or in Linux, gedit. So all these editors, if you see, they have some help, a better user experience for a code writer to go through the code, basically debug the code. Or debug is a far ahead feature, but a simple feature is when you write open some tag like p, so the corresponding close p tag is highlighted. So you know you are in which section and where to close and open it, or you are missing the tag. So all such functions, so we are planning to implement such functions in the Open edX HTML editor. So now it is easier said than done, basically because sometimes it is easier to create everything from scratch. OpenEdX is already a system, we'll have to rip it apart. The component, HTML component, we'll have to rip it apart. And then we'll have to make the modifications, integrate them, and then try and run all these things. So, yeah, it's kind of a challenge. Let's see what we can do.